Before electric lights became popular, kerosene was widely used in oil lamps and was one of the most important refinery products. Today, kerosene is primarily used as heating oil, as fuel in jet engines, and as a solvent for insecticide sprays. Welcome to GNP Animations. In this video, we are going to see how kerosene is made. Kerosene is a thin, clear liquid consisting of a mixture of hydrocarbons that boil between 150 and 275 degrees centigrade. While kerosene can be extracted from coal, oil, shale, and wood, it is primarily derived from refined petroleum. Kerosene is extracted from a mixture of petroleum chemicals, also known as crude oil, found deep within the earth. The crude oil itself derived from decayed organisms that were buried along with the sediments of early geological eras over tens of millions of years. This organic residue called kerosene was converted to crude oil by a pair of complex chemical processes known as diagenesis and catagenesis. The combination of these complex reactions creates a hydrocarbon mixture known as petroleum or crude oil. There are many steps involved in manufacturing of kerosene, but in this video we are simply going to see three steps. Step 1, collecting the crude oil. Step 2, separation of kerosene. Step 3, purification of kerosene. The first step in the manufacture of kerosene is to collect the crude oil. Finding crude oil reservoirs is a long and complex process. It can take years of research. These reservoirs can be at depths of more than 3000 meters or hidden under thick layers of salt deep below the seabed or trapped in geological faults where the rock is folded into complex structures. Seismic reflection imaging remains the most widely used geophysical technique in hydrocarbon exploration. And there are three primary types of drilling operations used to bring the crude oil to the surface: cable-tooled drilling, rotary drilling, offshore drilling. After oil is collected, gross contaminants such as gases, water, and dirt are removed. Since crude oil is a combination of many different hydrocarbon materials, it must be separated into its compounds. And that brings us to the second step, separation. Fractional distillation is one type of separation process. It involves heating the crude oil to separate its components. In this process, the stream of oil is pumped into the bottom of the distillation column where it is heated. The lighter hydrocarbon components in the mixture rise to the top of the column, and the most of the high boiling point fractions are left at the bottom. The columns used to separate lighter oils are proportionally tall and thin. Tall distillation columns are more efficiently separate hydrocarbon mixtures because they allow more time for high boiling point compounds to condense before they reach to the top of the column. The condensed liquid fractions can be collected separately. The fraction that is collected between approximately 150 and 250 degrees centigrade is kerosene. Step 3, purification. Once the oil has been distilled into fractions, further processing in a series of chemical reactions is necessary to create kerosene. Catalytic reforming, alkylation, catalytic cracking, hydroprocessing are four of the major processing techniques used in conversion of kerosene. This reaction process involves transferring the crude oil fraction into a separate vessel where it is chemically converted into kerosene. Once the kerosene has been reacted, additional extraction is required to remove the secondary contaminants that can affect oil's burning properties. For example, aromatic compounds such as benzene are one class of contaminant that must be removed. The following extraction techniques are used to purify kerosene: the Eudex extraction process, the sulfolane process, Lurgi aerosolvent process, dimethyl sulfoxide process, etc. The sulfolane process was created by Shell Company in 1962 and it is still used in many extraction units. The solvent used in this process is called sulfolane and it is a strong polar compound that is more efficient than glycol system used in Eudex extraction process. After extraction is complete, the refined kerosene is stored in tanks for shipping, and this is how kerosene is made.